Well, friends, welcome back. In this video, we're going to start working on the game settings so that the server can define the map and the map time, et cetera, and kick players from the lobby if they'd like. In the previous video, we got to the point where we can host a game. Just demo real quick. Host a game, pick a name, and we set up our player cards so that they appear in this list here. Clients can find a match. Once they find it, they should be able to accept and join. So we join, and our client has connected. Again, we're using the same project right now, so it's pulling the same save file information. If we had two versions of this project on our machine, we could go into the alternate project and delete the save file, which would allow us to have different information displayed here. So what we're going to do now is start working on the game settings window on the designer tab, and then we'll probably pause, and then we'll start doing the scripted side of that. So let's go ahead and open up the game settings window. It's under lobby, under UI, game settings. And go ahead and dock it to the top. We're also going to open up the host menu from our main menu. Let's go ahead and open up the host. Options, actually. Let's open up the options menu because there's some stuff in here that we want to use. So I'm going to take this border from the top here, copy, and then go to the game settings and paste it. And we no longer need the options, so I'm going to close that. And for this border, I'll kind of move it over. And actually, before we do that, let's delete this border. We don't need a canvas panel. So I'm going to delete this, canvas panel, and then paste it. All we need is this screen, because this is going to appear over our lobby menu. So we don't need a canvas panel, actually. All right, first thing here, this is not the player options. It is game settings. So let's change that to game settings. And the next thing that we'll do, I think we're actually going to change the way that this functions at the top here. Let's go ahead and, we're going to change the way this functions here. So select the game settings here and go ahead and wrap that. Right click, wrap with horizontal box. And inside this horizontal box, we're going to have some buttons. Let's add some buttons. Let's take a button, put it on top. Take another button, throw it in. And let's add some text on top of those buttons. So just drag text on top of the button, text on top of the button. And let's kind of close these. Let's take this button and just click it over so it appears one button on each side. And the horizontal box itself, let's go ahead. I think we can leave it like that. We'll make some changes here in a second. So the button here, let's call this the settings button. So we'll select it and say settings button. And this will be kick button, so kicking players whenever we click on this. Let's update the text to reflect that too. So text will say settings. And this will say something like kick player or something along those lines, whatever you want that to say. Now, our text in the middle here, what we'll do is we'll set that to fill. That's what we want to do. So we have game settings, and then on the left and the right, we have the settings. If we click that, then we have kick player. So that looks good. And let's see, let's go ahead and let's now collapse this. Don't need to enter your player name, so I'm going to delete that. Don't need a user player name, so I'm going to delete that. But we are going to use this section here. And I'm trying to think of the best way we want to do this. Because we don't need this text either. Let's delete that. We don't need that text. So what we'll do is, let's see, we have all of this information here. It's in a horizontal box right now. Let's replace this with a vertical box. No, we don't want to do that. Control Z, whoops. We want to wrap it with a vertical box. That's what we want to do. So we'll wrap with a vertical box. Thought we wanted to replace it. Now what we can do is take text, put that on top of the vertical box, so it appears above and below it. So we'll take this text and we'll move it up, and then we'll take another text inside the vertical box, like so. So what this will be is, when we're done with it, if we center this up, and we center this up, we can say something like at the top here, select map, and it'll have a map image here, and then we can press a button. This text down here will be the name of the map, so we'll say by default Arena 01, something like that. Okay, and this is, let's actually F2 on this and say select map widget, so. And then what we'll do is, let's take this whole thing, copy it, and paste it right next to it. Or no, that's this. So we need to wrap this with a horizontal box. So let's right click on this, wrap with a horizontal box. I'm kind of doing this on the fly here because I'm doing it a little bit different than my project that I set up. So let's copy this, paste it, so we have side-by-side settings like so. So we have select map widget, and this one will be for time, so we'll say select time widget. And it's not going to have an image in the center. Let's change this to say select time. And it also won't need this section down here, so it's something like this. The image here, we'll change that to some text. So let's kill this, actually. Let's kill this. Let's add some text in there instead. And we'll say that this text says 10 minutes by default. Now for this text, we're going to need to do some changes to this. That's super small, so we'll center this up. We'll increase the font size to say something like, I don't know, 48 or 52, something like that. So we'll have these two options side by side here inside of that. And we can add some padding to this. Let's add some padding, let's see. 10. We need it on each individual one, don't we? So on this one, we can add padding of 10. And on this one, padding of 10. A little bit more if you want to space them out, but that kind of puts them side by side, like so. Okay, so we have our basic settings there. What we're going to do now is take this vertical box here, and not this one. Both of these here, so that's this one actually. Or take this horizontal box here, we're gonna wrap this with a widget switcher. So let's wrap with widget switcher. And what we'll do now is we'll create a separate widget for when we choose the kick player option. This will go away and we'll have a new screen for kicking our players. And for this, we'll just use a vertical box. So we'll take a vertical box now, under panel. Drop that in, like so. Now when we select this, it goes away. For this, what we'll do is, let me see how we want to do this. We'll take some text inside that vertical box. And this text will say something like, select the player to kick. Actually, yeah, to kick. Something like that. Looks fine to me. Below that, we're going to be using a scroll box. So we'll take a scroll box now. Under panel. Drop that on top of the vertical box. So. And this scroll box auto is fine. It will populate this window. I think that's fine. The widget switcher itself, however, we're going to set this to fill. And we'll set our horizontal box to center. There we go. So that looks a little bit better. So our back and accept buttons are down at the bottom. Our game settings window will present us with these two options when we're on game settings. And then when we're on the kick player, then we can have our select a player to kick, and then the buttons for each player will appear in here. Let me just double check one thing. That's set to stretch. I think that's okay. I think that's okay for now. We'll come back and make adjustments if we need to, but this will get the job done for now. So our design actually is done. We're going to pause here, actually. This is a little bit shorter of a video than a longer one. We'll pause here because the scripting of this will take a little bit of time to set up. So we'll pick it up in the next video where we start working on the graph tab and provide the scripted functionality for our game settings window. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you then.